Hello students, today we are going to continue with the novel To Sir With Love. Yesterday we had seen the summary and theme of the novel. Today first we are going to see the synopsis of the extract. Synopsis here means the brief summary. In this extract, Breathwet recounts the half-yearly report of the Students' Council, in which the students of the school report to the faculty and other students on what they have been studying thus far. Now here we come to know that the writer, Breathwet, he recounts the half-yearly report, means midterm report of the Students' Council, in which the students of the school report to the faculty and other students on what they have been studying thus far, means what they have studied for the 6 months. Breathwet's class representatives speak knowledgeably about their coursework and place a considerable amount of emphasis on how much they have learned about different people, cultures, customs, and the importance of international and interracial cooperation. Now, your Breathwet's class, which was the highest class, you can say 12th standard of the school here, they speak, the class representatives here speak very knowledgeably, means they have great knowledge about the coursework, means what they have studied for these 6 months. And they place a considerable amount of emphasis on how much they have learned about different people, means they tell they have not only studied about the coursework, but they have also studied about the different people, cultures, customs, and importance of international and interracial cooperation. Miss Joseph and Denham, both students of Breathwet's class, preside over the meeting. Here, the class representative, Miss Joseph and Denham, they are both students. They preside over the meeting. At the outset, Mr. Florian, the headmaster, addresses the meeting with a lengthy but well-received presentation. Here we come to know Mr. Florian is the headmaster of the school. So at the outset means what? In the starting only, he addresses the meeting, and the whatever he tells, address means a formal speech. So in the speech, whatever the speech was very lengthy, but it was the presentation of the speech was very nice. So the you can say audience found it very interesting. One after another, each class gives a brief report of their progress. Means now after the principal's speech, now each class representatives were coming and they were giving report of their progress through their chosen representative on what they have been studying in each subject so far. I mean, in each subject, English, Math, Science, what they have learned, they have to tell here. A panel of teachers is chosen for each class to answer any questions regarding the report submitted by the class. Means there are teachers who are selected in a panel who will be answering to the question submitted by the class. The lowest class begins first. The lowest class begins first, and it is obvious as the students progress through the ranks, there is a marked development in their ability to express themselves. Now, the lowest class, the presentation starts from the lowest class, and they are saying here students progress through the ranks, means first rank, second rank, according to the development in their ability the ranks were given and they were expressing themselves. Mr. Breathwet's class, being the oldest, was the last one to present their report. Miss Joseph begins the highest class's proceedings by clarifying that the common theme underlying all their studies this term is the interdependency of mankind. Means Miss Joseph of the highest class, she starts by clarifying that the theme, what is the aim of their studies in this 6 month term, it is interdependency of mankind. Potter speaks in the field of maths. One student named Potter, he speaks in the field of maths, focusing on how greater understanding in the world is fostered by the use of common weights and measures. Means he tells how they have studied weights and measures in the curriculum, and it will help them, or it helps them to understand the world. Miss Peg and Jackson speak on geography. Miss Dare and Furman discusses the subject of physiology, with Furman stealing the show by exhibiting a model of a human skeleton. Means stealing the show means what? He attracts the audience, the people who are there in the meeting, by showing the model of skeleton and stressing the class conclusion that basically all people were same. And what did he try to conclude by showing the model of human skeleton? That we all human beings are same. There is no, you can say, we cannot discriminate human being on basis of the, you can say, color, caste, creed, anything. Miss Dodd reports on history. Miss Joseph on domestic science. Denham creates a stir by speaking on the required subject of PT and games. Denham, he speaks, he creates a stir means what? He attracts the attention of the audience by speaking on the topic or the subject PT and games, and complaining that the class was ill-conceived and pointless. Means they did not take the, they did not take this subject very seriously. He complained about them. Mr. Watson, Mrs. Dell Evans and Miss Phillips are chosen at random to answer students' question arising from the senior presentation. Now these three people are being chosen to answer the students' question. When Denham pursues his inquiry on the necessity of requiring all students to take PT, Mr. Weston responds quite ridiculously. Now when Denham, he pursues, means he tries to tell everyone that the this subject PT is very important for the students. So at that time Mr. Watson responds very quite ridiculously. Means he just, you can say, laugh, and he tries to tell that no, it is not important. Trying to bluster his way out of the subject, means he just laughs and he tells that no, it is not very important, and offering no coherent argument. Unexpectedly, the quiet and hesitant Miss Phillips steps in and gives a sturdy defense of the practice. And Denham, knowing that he has been outwitted, has no choice but to respectfully cease his heated protest. Means when here Denham was trying to tell everyone that this subject, physical training, PT, is very important for the student, but others were not really trying to accept what he was telling, and they were not trying to support him. So he thought here that it is better that he respectfully cease his heated protest, means stops here only. Breathwaite is immensely satisfied with the progress of the student of his class. But here you will find Breathwaite as a teacher is very satisfied or happy that the class has progressed very nicely. Now we will see the chapter, To Serve with Love. The half-yearly report of the Students' Council was on November 15. This half-yearly report was on November 15 and was one of the important days in the calendar of Greenslade School. It was very important day in the calendar of academic calendar of Greenslade School. I heard quite a deal about this occasion and became as excited as the children as the day approached. Here the writer Breathwaite is saying he had heard a lot about this occasion, half yearly report of the student, and how students are excited about it. So after hearing about all that, he also became very excited as the day approached. It was entirely their day, arranged, presented and controlled by them. It was their day, so students have made all the arrangement. They have made all the presentation. What is going to be there? They have seen everything is done properly, and they were controlled also. Means they have made all the arrangement. Management was also in their hand. I observed the activities of my class as they prepared for it, noting with pride the business-like way in which tasks were allocated and fitted into a neat program. Here, Braithwaite is saying, as a teacher, he observed his class making all the preparation for this day, and he noted with pride. He was feeling, he felt proud of himself that the students were so nicely handling this task. Business-like means what? Like mature people, the students were also handling everything, and everyone was given one particular responsibility, and it was means the task which was given, it was allocated one after the other very nicely. Program was handled very nicely by the students. There were whispered conferences with members of other classes in arrangement of it. Means one class representative were having conversation with the other class representative about the conferences and all. On that day, there was no assembly. The children arrived smartly dressed and polished. That day, assembly was not conducted, and students arrived in school very smartly dressed and polished. And Miss Joseph and Denham, who seemed to be the important officials for the occasion, moved about among their colleagues, ensuring that each one was ready to play his or her part. Now, there's two people here, Miss Joseph and Denham. They were from the highest class. So, they were the important official for the occasion. And so, they moved around among their colleagues and they tried to ensure that everything is ready. And all are ready to do their assigned task. A bell was rung at 10 a.m. and everyone trooped into the auditorium. 10 o'clock bell had rung and everyone trooped, means they moved together in large number to sit together in classes. Miss Joseph and Denham, the two most senior students, sat on the stage. They were the senior students, so they sat on the stage, one on each side of Mr. Florian, who, as soon as everyone was seated and silent, stood and addressed the school. And on each side of Mr. Florian, the principal head of the school, these two students, they sat on each side of the headmaster. And who, as soon as there was silence, everyone had taken their seat, he addressed the student. He spoke at length, reiterating the aims and policy of the school. Means he gave a lengthy speech, but he reiterated means what? To repeat something for emphasis. So what he wanted to emphasize, the aims and policy of the school and of the important contribution each child could make to the furtherance of those aims. Means he was also emphasizing that how each and every child can contribute to fulfill. Furtherance means what? To advancement of that scheme or intention. So, to furtherance of those aim, how each and every child can help or contribute. He gave praise wherever it was indicated, but insisted that there was yet a great deal to be done. He praised wherever he felt that student have done a good job. They have progressed nicely each and every class when they were giving their presentation, when they were reading out their report. So he used to praise them, but he also insisted that there was yet a great deal to be done. Means now they have to improve more by themselves towards a general improvement in conduct, cleanliness and the pursuit of knowledge. Means he said that still they have to learn more, still they have to improve more in their conduct, in their behavior, in cleanliness, hygiene and also in knowledge, to enhance the knowledge. As I listened, I realized that this man was in no way remote from his school. His remarks all showed that he identified himself with it and everyone in it. He then wished them success with the council meeting and left the stage to tremendous applause. Means here the writer is saying, you know, Braithwaite is saying when he listened, he realized that this man, the principal, is no way remote from his school. Means he wants, all his thoughts are related to his school only. His remarks all showed that he identified himself with it and everyone in it. Means he himself believes in those things, means improving the conduct related to hygiene and in pursuit of knowledge, and he wants other also to do that. He then wished success to the council meeting and left the stage. Means his speech was over and everyone applauded him for his speech. Things now moved quickly into gear. Means now one after the other, each class was presenting their report. First, Miss Joseph stood up and gave a short explanation of the council's purpose and its activities. Now here Miss Joseph, she gives explanation. What is the purpose of the council and what are their activities? Each class would report through its representatives on the studies pursued during the half year, which began after Easter. A representative having been chosen for each subject. Each subject, one representative was chosen from class, and that representative used to tell them that what they have learned from particular subject, from geography, from maths and all. Each subject, one representative was there. When all the classes had completed their reports, a panel of teachers would be invited to occupy the stage. Means when everyone, all the classes, when they finish presenting their report there, so a panel comes on stage and answer questions from the body of the hall on matters arising out of various reports. Means whatever they, the students, whatever report they have presented, there are, you can say there were other people also, students, parents, they were also listening. So whatever query was there in their mind, now this panel, there were few selected teacher, they were going to answer them. The selection of the panel, as with everything else, was entirely at the discretion of the children. Entirely at the discretion means what? Children had the freedom to decide who will be in the panel. And no member of the staff knew either how many or which teacher would be invited to sit. The reports began with the lowest or the youngest class first. These were mainly 12 year old who had joined the school the previous summer. Means the first class, they were just 12 year old who had joined class in previous summer. Most of them were shy and rather frightened at standing up before the entire school. It was their first time, or you can say first time they were on the stage, so they were very frightened and feeling shy also. But nevertheless, they managed it creditably. But still, they did gave the speech nicely. They had been newly introduced to the difficulties of seeking information for themselves, so their report was understandably rather short. Means it was their first time, and they were trying to, whatever they were trying to do or tell in their speech, it was the first experience. So their speech was very small. It was not very lengthy. Class after class was represented, and it was obvious that with each succeeding term, there was a marked development in their ability to express themselves. Now, as first standard student, when they were trying to express themselves, it was understood that they are not able to express it very nicely. They are not able to tell what they want to tell very nicely. But as class by class, it was going on, the highest higher classes were coming to give the report here, we come to know their ability to express was very fine. Much of the work was rather elementary, but to them it loomed large because they understood it, something of its relationship to themselves. Means much of the work was of elementary, the small classes, but we understand that they are not able to express themselves. But as the second, third, fourth, as the classes were going on, as the students were able to express themselves nicely, so we understand the connection that as they go to the higher classes, they will be able to express themselves how the other students are doing it. Throughout all the reports, the emphasis was on what they understood rather than on what they were expected to learn. Means here from the report we come to know the emphasis was not what they have learned from the curriculum or the syllabus. It was what they have understood. When the turn of my class came, I sat up anxiously. Means now when Braithwaite's class turn was there. So as a teacher, he was very anxious. From the list, he held his hand. Denham called out the names of the representative together with the subjects on which they would report. Means now Denham, he called the class representatives who were going to speak on each subject. So these were the students who are going to speak. Potter will speak on arithmetic, Sapiono, nature study, Miss Peg and Jackson, geography, Miss Dare, Furman, physiology, Miss Dodd, history, Denham, PT and games, Miss Joseph, domestic science. Now see what Braithwaite has to say. I felt terribly pleased and proud to see the confident courtesy with which Denham used the term Miss in addressing each of the senior girls. Means he was very happy and he felt very proud to see how confidently and very courteously Denham was using the term Miss while addressing to all senior girls. I felt sure that this would in itself be something for the younger ones to aim at, a sort of badge of young adulthood. Means he felt that the way he was addressing to the senior girls, the other students, the younger ones, when they are listening to it, they themselves also will learn from the way he is speaking. As their names were called, they walked up to the stage and took their seats with commendable gravity. Commendable means what? Deserving praise. And gravity means what? Extreme importance or seriousness. Means they were very confident. Miss Joseph then gave a short address, means she gave a short speech, formal speech. She said that their lessons had a particular bias towards the brotherhood of mankind and that they had been learning through each subject how all mankind was interdependent in spite of geographical location and differences in color and races. Means here she is trying to tell that though we all are different in colors and races, but geographically we all are interdependent on each other. All mankind are interdependent on each other. Then she called on Potter. Potter went on to speak of the work they had been. Potter went on to speak of the work they had done on weights and measure. Means he was going to tell about math. So he told them that how they learned weights and measures. Of the relationship between the kilogram and the pound, the meter and the foot. Means he also told them that how he learned about the relationship between the kilogram, pound, meter and foot. Student, today we will stop here only. We'll continue with the same novel in the next lecture. Thank you.